Well, you obviously, we've changed name recently as a company to Sunda Energy. We've stated very clearly our strategy is one that's focused solely on this region, which was a change from previously. And so with that much clearer sort of corporate setup, we are now looking at opportunities.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Sunda Energy CEO, Andy Butler. Andy, very good to speak with you. And you're out with an operation update on the Chuditch project in Timor-Leste. And it looks like you're making progress with funding for the project.
Yeah, well, thank you, Stephen. Good to see you again. And thanks for inviting me on. Yes, that's right. We put out an operational update this morning. We talked about a number of things. One of the key things there is funding. And we've discussed this before, and we've made some good progress. And we're very pleased to announce that one of the parties we're in discussion with is Pacific LNG, which is a private Singapore company with a team that has a very strong track record of creating value in this region through gas projects. So that those discussions are going well. As I've probably mentioned previously in discussions with you, a lot of the conversations we've been having with different parties around companies that are specialists to this region, specialists in gas, and Pacific LNG definitely fit into that category.
So this agreement with Pacific LNG is you've entered an exclusivity agreement during which you'll both conduct due diligence, I understand.
That's right. Yes, absolutely. And as part of that, the representative from Pacific LNG accompanied me in Dili and Timor-Leste last week. And we had some excellent meetings with some of our government partners, the minister, the regulator, our joint venture partner, Timor Gap, to talk around exactly that, our plans for drilling the appraisal well on Chuditch, but also looking beyond that, looking at ways that the field can be developed. And we do continue to enjoy very good, strong support from government on that. And it was great to introduce them to this party.
Andy, the exclusivity agreement also includes carve-outs for other potential funding partners. So could you have more than one funding partner for the project?
Yeah, I mean, as I've indicated previously, we do have a number of discussions that carry on. They are potentially complementary in the way you suggest, and we can see why, you know, different parties potentially bring different things and have different strengths. They would all fit into that category I was describing earlier of specialists in the region, specialists in gas. I'd say much more than that, but there are a few discussions in play beyond the Pacific LNG. That's the main one that we're talking about today.
Andy, we chatted in June, and that was when you entered the year three of the Chuditch production sharing contract. Since then, you say that you have continued your operational planning in earnest.
Yes, we're looking forward to drilling. We're on schedule to drill the appraisal well that we've described previously early next year. The procurement processes, the regulatory approval processes, the environmental impact assessments, and all of that, all going on schedule. There is a very broad number of things that are conducted as part of operational planning. We have an excellent team in-house that are coordinating that. We've got about 40 procurement streams for materials, goods, services that are required for the safe and effective execution of that drilling campaign. And again, we are liaising closely with our government partners, but the joint venture partner, Timor Gap, and the regulator in making sure that everything comes together. So we're on track with all our planning, and looking forward to it.
Andy, so as you make progress with Chuditch, you say you're also looking for new business opportunities in the region. Can you expand on that?
Obviously, we've changed name recently as a company to Sunda Energy. We've stated very clearly our strategy is one that's focused solely on this region, which was a change from previously. And so with that much clearer sort of corporate setup, we are now looking at opportunities that exist around the region and opportunities that are of the sort of scale and materiality that we've achieved with Chuditch. And we do see some very exciting potential. So, you know, we're focused very much on Chuditch at the moment, but we are sort of looking at other things that might come in and be complementary to it and on a similar scale, as I say. So hopefully we'll say more as some of those ideas progress.
Also in today's announcement, you said Rob Collins has been appointed to your board. So he's the chief financial officer and a good addition to the board.
Very much so. I mean, Rob was not on the board previously. He joined as CFO some months ago. But it's part of, again, that sort of corporate transition that we're going through, strengthening up many aspects of the company. Strong board is very much key to that. Rob's a very important member of the team, and so welcoming him to the board is an important step in the company's progression.
Well, I hope you'll keep us posted on progress on all those fronts. Andy, thank you very much for the update today.
Great to see you, Stephen. Thanks a lot. Take care.
Thank you. Sunda Energy CEO Andy Butler.